I'm Jeff Alpin, the Big Game Hunter. I'm a career and leadership coach, a former executive recruiter. I now coach people in organizations around job search, hiring more effectively, management, leadership, and resolving workplace-related issues. An article on Forbes.com, and I'll have a link to it in the show notes, it's called Why We Need a Healthier Narrative Around Aging in Work. So true. Let me just start off with reading the opening two paragraphs. I'm going to pause after the first one. Workers age 65 and above represent the fastest growing contingent of talent, yet that group is most overlooked. Add gender to the factor, and potential talent is even more discarded. Add race and gender to the equation, and the possibility of attaining work at 65 plus is almost impossible. So I keep seeing these articles about the war for talent. There's a lot of people that you're discarding and disregarding because they're too old, they're from a minority group, they're women, or they're non-binary for that matter. And thus, consider that that's an area that is underutilized. Second paragraph. Right now, as many people are turning 80 as there are babies being born. I'm going to pause there. Falling fertility rates mean nearly every country could have shrinking populations by the end of the century. I know we don't care about the end of the century. I don't care who's watching this. You're not going to be around then. And while many predicted another baby boom when the pandemic hit, the opposite occurred, with birth rates dropping around the world in 2020 in the U.S. In the U.S., the birth rate dropped 7%. So there's an issue here with how older workers are seen. And as the article says, if we don't provide employment opportunities for all aged workers, the projected number of 65 plus living in poverty is expected to double. Now, I know bias exists both ways. I've listened to enough younger workers complain about older workers that they're not seen and heard, but you're hired. And once you're in the workplace, that's really when the bias shows up, when no one listens to you because you're too young. For them, they're not even hired. And often they're not even interviewed because it's determined through some fantasy that they'll never fit in. The projection of a 60 to 80 year work life and increasing numbers of centenarians is just one indication that it's past time for a new and healthier narrative around aging and work. And remember, folks, these people are your future. If they're pushed out, remember, that's coming to you in a theater near you. That's going to be your future. So recognize that for older workers, once they're out of their current company, as often happens, it's hard for them to land. For you, in your 20s, 30s, 40s, and even early 50s, no problem, because you're not trying to deal with the ageist scenarios, or the stereotypes, I should say, that show up. Thus, if you're in the hiring area, whether it's an HR or a hiring manager, recognize there's a population of people that you're missing out on who are well-educated, who have a lot of experience, and frankly, you don't care if they fit in. It's not like you're trying to hire your best friend. You want to hire someone who's capable, who can do the job. And if the staff doesn't connect with them, frankly, they don't care. You know, the older worker doesn't care. She just wants to do their job and go home at the end of the day. They're not going to the bar and hanging out at the end. So you're missing out on a lot of folks. And for those of you who are in HR and can monitor this, recognize how your systems are set up to screen them out. Recognize how your hiring managers are screening people out on the basis of age, but they use the term too much experience. And see what you can do to correct this bias now, because if there really is a war for talent, as is being extolled in the media, you're missing out on a lot of capable people. Hope you found this helpful. I'm Jeff Altman. Visit my website, thebiggamehunter.us. There's a lot more in the blog to help you. In addition, if you're interested in one-on-one coaching, you can schedule time for a free discovery call or schedule time for coaching. I'd love to help you. There's also access to courses I have through the site. And connect with me on LinkedIn at linkedin.com/IN/thebiggamehunter. Have a terrific day and be great. Take care.